Where were you while the rest of us were eating together?
I don't recall being obligated to report my whereabouts to you.
Did you go find another hidey hole to read in? You need to change your ways, you know. You can't survive on books alone.
Surviving on meals paid for by you would be harder still.
You? Whatever. It doesn't take a genius to guess what you've been up to. You were investigating Sachin, weren't you? It was obvious from your notes. However, I don't believe his research alone would have been enough to pique your interest. His way of doing things is disturbing, while you... Well, to be fair, your philosophy disgusts me too, but you and Sachin are nothing alike. I don't imagine your views intersect at all. Egoism and nihilism are not the same thing.
My personal interest aside, Sachin's legacy is not entirely meaningless. He conducted experiments on a great scale and left his findings behind. Also, thanks for the compliment. But I'm actually just passing through. I didn't come here for the conversation. Well, not this one at least.
What do you mean? What topic of conversation could be more sacred among scholars than the exploration of differing philosophies?
Well, based on what I've learned, Sachin and his disturbing way of doing things, as you put it, is very likely to have met your father 20 years ago.
What did you say? Wait, so... No. Surely that doesn't mean... So that's why he thought I looked familiar. My father must have gone into the desert due to his influence.
I'm afraid so.
Good thing I shattered that diadem. From now on, nothing like that will ever have to happen again.
The boundaries of knowledge are ever expanding. Someone else will inevitably pick up the same line of research one day, and Vahumana regards it as a reasonable research direction.
Oh, not this again. Even if you're right and people are bound to fall into the same intellectual traps, things won't necessarily go the same way again next time. You have to admit that the actions of one individual don't always predict the behavior of the group, and vice versa. Take Sachin, for instance. He's quite an anomaly.
And so is the one who stopped him. You. Conflicts of this nature are indeed exceptional, but it will occur again in the future. You said it yourself. The actions of one individual cannot predict the behavior of a whole group. You know that not everyone would have chosen as you did.
Even so, I stand by my views. You can forget about trying to convince me.
That's fine. We've been arguing over this for years, and I don't hold any hope of you understanding. The issue we're debating has long since moved on from who's right and who's wrong.
Thanks for letting me know all this.
What?
I said, thanks for letting me know. Hey, stop acting like you didn't hear me. You're doing this on purpose, aren't you?
They say that earnest thanks should be given thrice, so one more time, please.